is lovely to see you all. It is wonderful to have you all here. Welcome. There are faces that I sort of recognise from this bit upwards, and there are faces that I don't recognise. So, welcome to everybody. My name is Julie, Reverend Julie Hardy. Welcome to St. Nicholas Church on this special day when we're going to look at, listen to carols and look at the, just hear so much. And as I look around the church, I'm seeing new things as I look. Each time I turn, there's something to look at. And it's beautiful, isn't it? Thank you so much to all our flower arrangers, to the people who have created our beautiful cribsy. I must admit, I nearly said hello to them as I walked in. I got carried away. just amazing. And I know they've actually moved home this year. And it looks amazing, doesn't it? How good it is. Welcome everybody. Please come in and join us. It's lovely. And so today is the third Sunday of Advent. And Advent is an adventure. It's a time of discovery, learning more about God and about Jesus. And it's a journey of hearing the good news. And so today is the day we light our third Advent candle. And here, we're really lucky, we have two lots of Advent candles. This side is the traditional side, where we have the patriarchs and we have the prophets, and today we think of John the Baptist, who went ahead of Jesus and proclaimed that he was coming. And so hopefully this is going to light. Is it going to do anything? Come on, you can do it. I'll just stand here a while, okay. Oh goodness me, it's getting there, folks. Please, like, you're gonna do it? Yes, there we go. So that's John the Baptist, the light of the good news that Jesus is coming. And then over here, we have love, joy, hope, and peace. And so today we light the third Advent candle, and I think it's for peace today. I was going to say peace. There we go. That's good. So we light our third one for peace. And I think we'll all agree we do need peace in the world. Definitely. And we need peace in our lives. Now this is where wearing a mask is no good because you can't blow it out. Just a minute. There we go. So, the things they don't tell you that you have to do. Anyway, so we have peace. So let's just have a prayer before we begin. Lord Jesus, we thank you that you are the Prince of Peace. We thank you for the peace that you offer into all our lives. Peace and calm. Peace and gentleness. In your great and glorious name we pray, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, let's put this down. Our Advent candles are lit, which means we can begin our act of worship. And so on the front page is a short little verse here. A child was born at Christmas. A child was born at Christmas when Christmas first began. The Lord of all, a baby small, the Son of God made man. For love is ours at Christmas, and life and light restored. And so we praise through endless days the Saviour, Christ the Lord. Beautiful. And so we're now going to hear Once in Royal David City.
Stood a lowly cattle shed where a
thank you, Linda and Val, for singing that. So we're on page 2. Beloved in Christ, may it be our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels in heart and mind, to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, and with the Magi adore the child lying in his mother's arms. Let us read and mark Holy Scripture, the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought by this holy child. And let us make this church dedicated to St. Nicholas, glad with our carols of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of his whole world, for peace and goodwill over all the earth, for unity and friendship within the church. He came to build, and especially in the dominions of our sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth. And because this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us at this time remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick in body and in mind, and those that mourned, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, and all who have no peace or comfort at this season of goodwill. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and was with whom, in this Lord Jesus, we forevermore one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself hath taught us. So let us say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The Almighty God, bless us with his grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of Angels bring us all. Amen. And so we're going to hear our first song.
And from now there won't be any announcements, but the service will just run through. The mic is working, is it? Yeah. The first reading comes from Isaiah. The prophet Isaiah foretells the coming of the Saviour and the peace that Christ will bring. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this, and there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge. Thanks be to God.
Good morning, everyone. I'm going to sing the carol, "It Came From Upon the Midnight Clear." It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all-gracious King. The world in solemn stillness laid to hear the angels sing. Still through the chalk-cloven skies they come, with peaceful wings unfurled, and still their heavenly music blows o'er all the weary world. Above its sad and lonely plains they bend on hovering wing, and ever o'er its babble sounds the blessed angels sing. Yet with the woe of sin and strife the world has suffered long, beneath the angel's strain have rolled 2,000 years of wrong. And man at war with man hears not the love song which they bring. Oh, hush the noise, ye men of strife, and hear the angel sing. For lo, the days are hastening on, by prophet bards foretold, when with the ever-circling years comes round the age of gold, when peace shall over all the earth its ancient splendors fling, and the whole world give back the song which now the angels sing.
The second reading. The angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said,
"Greetings, favoured one. The Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him a throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel disappeared from her. Thanks be to God.
Jesus. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one unto his own city. And Jesus and Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
He became a little child, I a child, and thee a lamb. We are called by his name, little lamb, God bless thee, little lamb, God bless thee.
The shepherds go to the manger. There were that night shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy to all people. Today, in the city of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, heaven and on earth peace, goodwill towards men." When the angels had left them, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see what has come to pass." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
Julie and I are doing this together, and we'd like you to join in for the last verse. While shepherds watched their flocks by night, all seated on the ground, an angel of the Lord came down, and glory shone around.
"Fear not," said he, "for mighty dread had seized their troubled mind. Glad tidings of great joy I bring to you and all mankind."
It's still the angel.
It's still the angel, is it? I'm sorry, this angel, I've forgotten that. "To you in David's town this day is born of David's line a Saviour who is Christ the Lord, and this shall be the sign. The heavenly babe you there shall find to human view displayed, or simply wrapped in swaddling clothes and in a manger laid."
Thus spoke the angel. Suddenly appeared a shining throng of angels praising God, who thus addressed their joyful song. "All glory be to God on high, and to the earth be peace, to those on whom his favour rests, goodwill shall never cease."
The wise men are led by the star to Jesus. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he'd gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And he sent the wise men to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." When they'd heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. Thanks be to God.
We three kings of Orient are, bearing gifts we traverse afar. Field and mountain, moor and mountain, follow yonder star.
Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
Born a king on Bethlehem plain, gold I bring to crown him again, king forever, ceasing never, over us all to reign.
Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
Frankincense to offer have I, incense owns a deity nigh. Prayer and praising, gladly raising, worship him, God most high.
Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
Myrrh is mine, its bitter perfume, breathes a life of gathering gloom. Sorrowing, sighing, bleeding, dying, sealed in a stone-cold tomb.
Glorious now we see him arise, King and God and sacrifice. Hallelujah, hallelujah, earth to heaven replies. O star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding,
by Godfrey Rust, a contemporary English churchman and poet, amongst other things. Of course, the Epiphany is the name given to the manifestation to the infant Christ of the wise men. It's also come to mean a sudden revelation or insight, a moment when you suddenly understand or suddenly become conscious of something that's very important to you. And I think this poem says that exactly. A stable's a good place for revelations. Some of the most profound discoveries are made in back rooms, half by accident, by people half exhausted, looking for something else. Just as we felt like giving up, when the whole thing had become ridiculous and had gone on much too long, and we were blaming everybody else for our mistakes, we came upon the unexpected answer in the most unlikely place. A speechless, thoughtless, helpless child who just lay there, needing to be loved. In this defiance of all natural things was born the enabling power of sacrifice, a being whose ambition was to seek its own destruction and then call upon his followers to do nothing else. What kind of way was this to rule a world? He just lay there, needing to be loved. It would be stopped. Each Herod would conspire for its destruction when they cannot tempt it with possessions, nor subdue it with pain, nor lull it to sleep with alcohol or television. Here was something we could not buy or cure, digitize, transplant, promote, update, invest in, analyze, or write a business plan for. He had no army, textbook, voter's mandate, or computer markup language, with which to implement this great design. He just lay there, needing to be loved. It was the most implausible demand. Anything else we might negotiate, but not this secret life secured through death. Grace, born out of deprivation. Grace, born of the endurance of the oppressed. Grace, born of the hardships of the poor. Grace, born of the forgiveness of the intolerable. Grace, born in the dignity of silence. Grace, born from incomprehensible submission to the absolute abuse of power. In the strength of his weakness, he just lay there, needing to be loved. Eons after energy exploded into matter, here in this stable was let loose a yet more potent power, shedding the fabric of his former life like an old coat, reckless that the truth would prove, for all he knew, fatal to everything which he had thus far clung. Our gifts were tokens. There was nothing more to do but leave the child to his own terrible story and return by different routes to our own countries, strangers to us now, yet seeing them as if for the first time, how they just lie there, needing to be loved.
Matthew chapter 2, verses 13 to 23. Escape to Egypt from Herod as he plots to destroy Jesus. When the Magi had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. "Get up," he said, "take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him." So he got up, took the child and his mother during the night and left for Egypt, where he stayed until the death of Herod. And so was fulfilled what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I called my son." When Herod realized that he'd been outwitted by the Magi, he was furious, and he gave orders to kill all the boys in Bethlehem and its vicinity who were 2 years old and under, in accordance with the time that he'd learned from the Magi. Then what was said through the prophet Jeremiah was fulfilled. A voice is heard in Ramah, weeping and greatly mourning. Rachel weeping for her children, refusing to be comforted because they're no more. After Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother and go to the land of Israel. For those who were trying to take the child's life are dead." So he got up, took the child and his mother and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was reigning in Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. Having been warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee, and he went and lived in a town called Nazareth. So was fulfilled what was said through the prophets, that he would be called a Nazarene. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Wartime Christmas by Joyce Kilmer. Led by a star, a golden star, the youngest star, an olden star. Here the kings and the shepherds are, a-kneeling on the ground. What did they come to the inn to see? God in the highest, and this is he. A baby asleep on his mother's knee, and with her kisses crowned. Now, is the earth a dreary place? A troubled place? A weary place? Peace has hidden her lovely face and turned in tears away. Yet the sun, through the war cloud, sees babies asleep on their mother's knees. While there are love and a home and these, there shall be Christmas Day.
Ninth reading, St John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Christmas prayer. Into our world, as into Mary's womb, come, Lord Jesus. Into the forgotten place, as into the stable, come, Lord Jesus. Into the lives of the poor, bringing hope. Into the lives of the powerful, bringing caution. Into the lives of the weary, bringing rest. Into the lives of the wise, bringing restlessness. And into our lives and longings, whatever our estate, come, Lord Jesus. This is the good news. Christ is coming, and blessed are those who wait on the Lord. Therefore, come quickly, Lord. Amen.
So before we say, I want to say the final blessing, I want to say thank you to all our readers, all our singing, all the people who have been involved in this event, because it's been beautiful, really beautiful. We can't sing, but I think all of us, as those were being sung to us, we were singing along in our heads, we were tapping our toes, and it was special. So thank you to everybody. It really was beautiful, and we've got a little bit more to go. So thank you, Yvonne, for putting that all together. It's a lot of work in asking all these people, so I'm putting it together. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Can I just add something? I don't know if you're aware that actually we've made about 40 to 50 arrangements for people to have in the village, and they'll be distributed probably on Wednesday this week. If there is somebody here who knows somebody special to them, or somebody who's suddenly ill, just have a word with myself or Sandra as you go, and I'm sure we could let you have one, because we do have a few spare. And but if you're taking one to someone we're already going to, then we'll advise you of that. But please do have a word if there's somebody special you'd like to give an arrangement to.
So that is just wonderful that we can spread the Christmas good cheer. So just marvellous. So let's stand. We've done a lot of sitting. Let's stand for the blessing. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Mary and Joseph, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you all, and all those you hold in your heart this Christmas. Amen. So we're going to listen to Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Shall we remain standing to Hark the Herald Angels Sing like this?
Thank you.
lovely just to hear that carol that we know so well, and at the same time for these children to come and see this beautiful crib. Just so special. So everybody, let us go in peace to bring love and joy into our homes this Christmas.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Amen. Enjoy the rest of your week. I hope we get to see you at some point over Christmas. Take care. God bless. Stay safe.